Every day, people get their MetaMask wallets hacked and they lose all their crypto there. However, if they would have had a $60 or $160 hardware wallet like Ledger connected to their MetaMask, those people would almost guaranteed have not lost all their crypto. In this video, I'll tell you how easy it is to get your MetaMask hacked, how you can prevent it with a Ledger device, and a step-by-step guide on how to set it up with your MetaMask on the Binance Smart Chain so that you can secure your crypto and trade safely. Take note, do not buy any crypto hardware wallets from other websites other than the official ones, because there has been many people that have bought from secondhand places where the wallets ends up being bugged, and once you transfer over your crypto, you lose it all. If you are interested in getting a Ledger wallet, you can check the link in the description below, which will take you to Ledger's official website where you can safely buy them. I am no financial advisor, I am just sharing info on how to use the Ledger wallets. See the timestamps below if you want to just see the setup guide. If you are like me and have a lot of different crypto coins everywhere, including in MetaMask, because many crypto projects does not have a native wallet, then you should be a little bit worried about your MetaMask wallet. As a MetaMask user, all it takes for you to get hacked is that you visit a website that asks you to sign using your MetaMask, and if that website is run by hackers and you sign, then they now got access to your wallet and your crypto. It is that easy for them. And people like us that go around looking at new different small cap crypto projects always end up seeing a lot of websites that want you to sign using your MetaMask. And sadly, there is a lot of people that get hacked this way, probably every day. But you can avoid this risk just by using a Ledger wallet, because you can with your Ledger just make another side account on your already existing MetaMask, and you will use that new side account just like a regular account. The only difference is that when you want to make a transaction on that account, you have to confirm it using your Ledger. So that is the only difference. You need to verify it manually with the press of a button. It is that simple. And honestly, making your MetaMask assets that much safer by such a cheap device is a no-brainer for me, at least. Now I'll show you a step-by-step guide on how to set up your Ledger, connect it to your MetaMask and your Smart Chain network, and use it for a transaction on your new side account. When you have your new Ledger device, open it up and plug it into your computer. You see the welcome screen, click right. Here it says to download Ledger Live, so I will just download Ledger Live program, nothing else. And then back at the Ledger device again, click right till you see this screen, click both buttons, click right till you see setup new device. Double click and choose a PIN code. Then you'll be asked to write down your recovery phrase. You can do that on the papers that followed with your Ledger. Never show these words to anyone. You need to write them down in order. So click right until you see this, click both buttons, and then write down your words. Then it should now say your recovery phrase is set. Right click and right click, and press both buttons to continue. And it should now say that your device is ready. Click both buttons on dashboard to go to the dashboard, and now you're done with the Ledger setup step. Now you want to open Ledger Live. Make sure your Ledger wallet is connected to your computer, click get started, agree to the terms of usage, select your device, then click here, set up a new device, right click, right click, right click, and then let's do that, and then click OK, I'm ready. Continue, check my nano, and then confirm on your device. All good, and then click continue. And then on Ledger Live, click on manager, and then first update your firmware using the button up here. You'll need to confirm here as well on your Ledger by using your PIN code. And now that you have updated, you need to install the Ethereum app here in Ledger Live. So click install here, and when it is installed, check that the Ethereum app is updated as well. If there isn't any button saying update, it is the latest version. Now, when the Ethereum app is installed, close down Ledger Live, pick up your Ledger wallet, and right-click until it now says Ethereum. That is the Ethereum app. Double-click to enter the app, then right-click and right-click until you see settings. Enter into settings, and there you should see blind signing, and it says not enable. You want to click that so it says enabled. Then just go right and right and right until it says back, and click that to get out of there. Now, first open Ledger Live again, go to Manager, on Ethereum click Add Account, confirm using your Ledger wallet. Now when it says Add New Account, rename it to something with Binance Smart Chain or BSC or something similar, and then click Done. Now you want to connect your Ledger to MetaMask, so open up your MetaMask account, Make sure you are on the Smart Chain Network. If you don't have that yet, add it by clicking here, add network, and add the following info. And then you have the Smart Chain Network set up. Now go into MetaMask, click here, click Connect Hardware Wallet, click Ledger, and before you click on Continue, pick up your Ledger wallet and open the Ethereum app. Then you can click Continue on your computer again. A window should now pop up and click Connect. And this screen should now pop up as well. Choose whichever account you want. I chose the top one and click Unlock. Confirm this on your Ledger wallet. And now you have your Ledger MetaMask side account. Here is your very own Binance Smart Chain address for your Ledger side account. So if you want to send Smart Chain tokens to your Ledger, just send them to your address here. And now it basically works just like a regular MetaMask account. You can still switch between your side accounts up here. And then now, every time you want to make a transaction, let's say on PancakeSwap, what you essentially only need to do is that when you confirm a transaction, you have to confirm it on your Ledger wallet. And it looks like this. So when you want to make a transaction in PancakeSwap and you click confirm on the computer, a transaction pops up in your Ledger wallet. You will have to click right and right to see the details and then right until you see this. And if you double click here, you confirm the transaction. And first then is your transaction sent away to be confirmed. So that's it. If you found this tutorial helpful, consider helping me out with a like. Thank you for watching and I'll see you in the next one. Bye bye.